No. Generally, oaks and maples don't root rot, and then maple is not susceptible anyhow. So it's only between oak trees. And in my 30 years plus experience, I generally don't see root rot between red oaks and white oaks, even though the literature says there are a small percentage that can. And in the red oak family members, I've been out on three separate sites in the last 30 years in which red oaks and black oaks, members of the same family, both with pointed leaves, I don't think the average person can tell them apart. I did not see root grafting in three separate occasions between red and black.
Different species.
They're different species, even though the literature says that they can root graft.
Yep. What is the fungicide?
The fungicide is propiconazole. And I don't know, I hope that's in one of my handouts. I think I have it written up here anyhow, so. As I mentioned, oak wilt, it's a very litigious disease. Here's another oak wilt horror story. This was near Holland, Michigan a few years ago. And I wanted to point out, you can see all the dead trees in this photograph. This is an oak here. And the homeowner told the arborist, I don't think you need to prune that one. And so you can see what happens when the trees are pruned versus not pruning. But here's the clincher on this thing. This arborist knew about oak wilt, so he painted every wound, which is our recommendation. There's his paint on every wound. Okay, but all the trees came down with oak wilt that he pruned. Why?
Spiking.
He went to all that trouble of painting every wound, but the spike marks he left was a big enough wound to allow the sap beetles to transmit the disease. Yes?
Robert, how much time do you have after a wound occurs of significant size to paint it, to prevent it, and how often does that work? 100%?
If you get a good coverage on this, it should work 100% of the time. As far as timing goes, you have to paint it as soon as the wound is made. Sap beetles begin arriving within minutes. And keep in mind, just keep in mind for a minute, if you're pruning a big oak tree, the very first cut is going to draw them in from hundreds of yards off. So they're going to be there. And the next cut, and the next cut, and the next cut, 20 or 30 cuts, and they're right there within seconds. So it has to be done immediately.
But you're referring to trees and pruning that's taking place after the cutoff date.
Pardon me now?
You're referring to trees when they should not be pruned.
Yeah.
Okay.
I prefer they not be pruned, but if you have to do emergency pruning for some reason,
okay.
This is a step that should work as long as, you know.
What do you paint them with?
What do you paint them with? There's a lot of different tree paints out there. I often recommend just a latex paint. Anything to provide a barrier from the sap beetle transmitting fungus. Yes? I'm sorry, I can hear you. Oh, storm damage?
Right.
We're going to get to that in just a second. Okay?
There's literature out there that that states somewhere between 6 to 8 to 10 minutes that the beetle will hit that wound. And that was Jenny Jesuick, I think, had that research.
Yeah. It's
so what you'd like to see is the professional up there, you know, with the pruning pole that needs to happen and the paint, the other hand, and
yeah,
pruning and painting and pruning and painting.
Yeah, so I've got a couple slides here on storm damage, and I'll address that in a little bit more in detail. Oh, storm damage. Okay. Here's an oak on the MSU campus. You can see this big wound here from storm damage. Are we concerned about oak wilt?
No.
Why not?
Winter.
It's winter. It turns out that wounds on oak trees are only attracted to sap beetles for about 5 to 7 days. So that's a very important key factor to know. Here's a wound up north of Manistee, Michigan. There's the wound from a storm injury. And that tree died with oak wilt. And from there, it will go underground and kill many oak trees around here. It's not stopped. So types of injury, predisposing, trees to oak wilt, pruning, storm injury, climbing spikes. I can't pronounce that, but
disco.
Lawnmowers. Disc golf. Many of you have seen the damage from disc golf. That's definitely enough of an injury to create wounds for oak wilt. That's probably going to occur primarily on smaller trees. Much larger trees are probably going to resist that. But any of these kind of injuries can introduce oak wilt. Now, one thing I've been in conflict with some people, including the state agencies, they say stumps cannot become infected. I know they can. I've seen it. So when you cut down the tree, let's say you're going to put on a new addition to your house, you want to remove an oak tree, you expose the stump, that stump can become infected. The roots of that stump can live for quite a few years after the tree is cut down. So that stump becomes infected, the fungus goes underground to your other trees in your yard.
Even if you grind the stump?
That's what you need to do. Either cover the stump, paint it, you can cover it with soil or mulch, or grind it out. Grinding should occur within a day or two, and that should be fine. Here's a development in Holland, Michigan. This area is opened up, and I'm waiting to follow this to see if these stumps, this is a neighborhood over here, which may be root grafted with some of these stumps. So I'll be following this in the next couple years. Epicenter, we talked about. Here's another oak wilt horror story. It seems like the worst of humanity comes out when it comes to oak wilt. This is an oak tree here. Someone attended one of my lectures, actually a turf, professional turf person. And he said he thought that looked like oak wilt, so this condominium association from West Bloomfield called me out. I confirmed it. I was looking at the tree, and an elderly gentleman come home that lived in this condo here. He was in his mid-80s. I said, it looks like this oak tree died. He said, yeah, I don't know what happened to it. There were leaves on the ground and so forth. I saw this recent pruning here, so I asked him, looks like the tree has been pruned recently. He said, yes, my neighbor told me I need to prune the tree because the branches were hitting my roof and it's going to destroy the roof of my condo. So I'll call him Yoda, the nice elderly gentleman. The neighbor I'll call Darth, the dark side. And what I found out from this, first of all, notice these branch wounds here. They're all facing away from his condo. That threw up a red flag quickly to me. Something's going on here. So I did some scouting around the area, and in the back of Darth's, I found two large stumps. And what had happened was he had pruned his trees. They died of oak wilt. And in order to defray the cost of removal, so those trees, he split the cost with this pruning job with the neighbor.
God.
It was terrible. It was, because you can imagine, it probably wouldn't cost much at all to prune those branches off compared to removing two large trees. So, again, the ugly side of humans come out. It turns out I wrote a report for this. And by the way, the condominium association owns these trees. The condo owners are not supposed to touch them. And so Darth here was fined severely. and he had to eat all the costs of Oak Grove remediation on the entire condominium complex.
Yes.
Justice sometimes prevails. Here's another Oak Grove horror story. And this is along Lake Michigan down here. I got a call from an elderly woman one day, and she said they've owned this property along Lake Michigan for over 100 years. Some lumberman stopped by and said, if you let us harvest your trees now, you can make some money off of them. But Oakwilt is only 10 miles away. And so if Oakwilt gets here and kills these trees, I'll have to charge you $4,000 a piece to take them down. So you can imagine she was beside herself. And so I calmed her down and I said, basically, Oakwilt may never get there. First of all, even if Oakwilt gets in there, the trees that it kills are perfectly fine for lumber. You can harvest it then and then undergo Oakwilt remediation on the property. But I told her, just don't worry about it. Learn about Oakwilt. Don't damage your trees. Don't prune them, and so forth. But as you can see, there's a lot of people trying to make hay on Oak Wilt. Here's another one, which I call the Hatfields and McCoy. Can you tell which of these neighbors is a gardener and which one is not? The woman that lived in this house here didn't like the leaves of this tree falling on her pavement all the time in the fall. So she decided to have this tree pruned. And this is a tree here showing it's got oak wilt from the pruning that the neighbor did. And there's, by the way, the law states that you're allowed to prune up to your property line, a neighbor's tree. But the law also states you cannot damage a tree or kill it. So her pruning ended up killing this tree. And this, there's the prune marks there, some big branches. And there's the tree back there. Now, all these oaks are in jeopardy here in the neighborhood because of that. So they underwent oak remediation. I think it was settled out of court. But I wrote a report for it and everything, so.